Okay, so this time let's now move on to the trust analysis. So for this trust analysis, we have two assumptions. So first assumption is that all loadings are applied at the joint zone. Here in our, let's say this is the picture of our truss. It says that it is assumed that the loads are always at the joints. This is the joints of the truss. The weight of the truss members are assumed to be negligible, so we do not consider the weight of these members. Next, number two, the joint of the truss members are modeled as internal hinges or pins. So that is why there's no moment reaction at the joint. So if we assume that each points here as part as pins, then the reaction has no moment members. Okay, so we have two methods in analyzing the truss. We have the method of joints, and later on we will discuss the method of sections. So first, let us have an example using the method of joints. So our problem is to determine the actual forces on members AB. Let us determine the forces at this member AB, AC, and BC. So we have three unknown numbers to be solved. We have AB, AC, and BC. So the first step is to determine the support reaction. So here we have support reaction at A and B. So we have support at A and support at B. So for this, for this support, this picture here is a pin support. So pin support, if you go back to your lecture, pin support has two reactions. So that's reactions along X and also along Y and vice versa. While this kind of picture here at the drawing, it is called the roller support. So please review your lecture. And it has one reaction. It's perpendicular to this area, either going upward or going downward. Okay? So first step is to determine the support reactions. So here, like what I have said, pin support has two reactions. So it has AX and AY. So first, you must assume the direction of your support, either going to the right or going to the left. And up or down. So there's no problem regarding that. Basta just assume the direction, and later on your computation, if your value of your AX or AY becomes negative, then your assumption is not correct. So therefore you must change the direction of your assumption. For example, here the value of AX that you later on computed is negative. So instead of going to the right, the real value of AX is going to the left. Okay. So same as here, since roller support has only one reaction, then let's assume that it is going upward. Since we have here two forces going downward, so there must be a support reaction to begin this truss stable. Okay. So at point B, you have 400 newton at joints D, you have 800 newton. Okay. And also what do you call this? Also the angle between the members and the distance between each joints are given. Okay. So after determining the support, after you draw the support using the free body diagram, you can now apply the equilibrium equation. So what are the equilibrium equations again? The summation of forces is equal to zero and moment is equal to zero. So let's apply first. So by the way, again, there's no problem which you want to solve first, either fx, fy, or moment. So it's up to you. So for me, I solve first for the value of AX. So AX, summation of forces at X. So as you know, this AX is the only force along X direction. So we have AX is equal to zero. Therefore, the value of this one is equal to zero, since there is no forces that must that the AX must support. Okay, so for the value of AY, we have the summation of force Y is equal to zero. So what are the forces Y? We have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So assuming positive is going upward, so we have positive AY plus EY, and then minus 400 and 800. And my technique here is transpose. All going upward, I wrote it to the left side, and all going downward, I wrote it on the other side. Okay, instead of using, or instead of writing AY plus EY minus 400 minus 800, I just directly wrote all the opposing direction to the right part of the equation. Okay, so 400 plus 800. So from here, we have two unknowns. We have AY and EY. So let's just say that this is our equation 1. You can now add these two values here to simplify our equation 1. And then, since we don't know pa din the value of AY and EY, let's now get another equilibrium equation. But for now, this is now in terms of moment. Okay, so to cancel out one unknown, the technique is to moment at the point where your unknown forces exist to cancel extra unknown force. So here I moment at point A. So if you moment at point A, automatically the AY and XY has no moment arm, so they are just equal to zero. And if you moment at point A, let's say clockwise is positive moment at A, so we have three forces acting upon this body. So we have 400 positive, sense if we, you imagine if we apply this force, it will cause a clockwise rotation to this member. Okay, so positive 400 times its perpendicular distance or moment arm is 1, plus also it will cause positive moment, so 800, while the perpendicular distance is 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. Okay, and then for EY, it will cause your thrust to rotate counterclockwise. So it is against our sign convention, then it must be a negative. So we have negative EY, we don't know the value, times the perpendicular moment arm is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 meters. Therefore, from this equation, we can now compute the value of our EY, which is equal to 700 Newton. Okay? And then, from equation 1, we can now solve the value of our AY. Since we know the value of our EY, then we need to substitute the 700 there for our equation 1. And then, you will remain unknown. Remaining unknown will be the AY. So, again, our AY is 500 Newton. Okay. As here, you can see that the reactions AY, AX, and EY, AX, AY, and EY are